Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December the 18th of 2020, well, it is titled Diamond in the Sky. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image taken just a couple of days ago on December the 14th, where if you happen to be located in South America and parts of Argentina and Chile, you had the chance to see a total solar eclipse. Now, this is not quite a total solar eclipse at the image here. This is just an instant around the time that the eclipse was total. And right before and right after, we get what is sometimes called the diamond ring effect. And that occurs when just one tiny bit of the sun is visible along the edge of the moon. So you'll see this right before and right after totality. And we can see that bright portion of the sun right off to the left hand side here. And also around the sun, you can also see a number of solar prominences sticking up around the edge of the moon there. And we have a very lucky coincidence here in that the moon and the sun are almost exactly the same size in the sky. Now, that makes eclipses relatively rare and confined to very specific locations on the Earth when they do occur, but it does allow us to see the external layers of the sun that are normally invisible. So the prominences are always there, but they are greatly overwhelmed by the brightness of the sun itself, so we cannot see those. And in images where the sun is completely blocked out, we can also see the solar corona or the atmosphere of the sun. Now, these are things that are always present there, but simply cannot be seen because the surface of the sun itself is so overwhelmingly bright. So here we do get to see the little bit of the sun as well as the bits around the edge of the moon. And the dark spot there is actually the moon in the middle. So the moon is passing directly in front of the sun. And due to the geometry of the Earth, Moon, and Sun and their orbits, this happens about every 6 months somewhere on the Earth. We get to see an eclipse, either a solar eclipse like this one, or a lunar eclipse where the moon will pass into the Earth's shadow. Now, they won't occur everywhere on the Earth because they are limited to a very specific region. It is where the moon's shadow touches the Earth, and that shadow is only a number of miles wide. So if you're not in that particular location, you will not see a total solar eclipse. So that is why they are so rare and why the total solar eclipse of 2017 that occurred in August of that year was so prominent, having gone right across the United States and leaving large chunks of the United States to be able to see, if not the total part of the solar eclipse, at least a very significant portion of the solar eclipse to be visible. So here we have an example of another solar eclipse demonstrating the diamond ring effect that is seen from the solar eclipse that occurred on December the 14th of 2020. So that was our picture of the day for December the 18th of 2020. It was titled Diamond in the Sky. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Returner. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.